will discuss about constructivism today. So let's start. Learners communicate with each other and share their understandings, feeling and knowledge and experience to come up with a new knowledge. The teacher, the facilitator and the learners are encouraged to interact, exchange views and experience, meaning and knowledge that is based on the needs. Apart from that, teaching's analytical logical problem solving strategy is advised to teach creative problems solving, which prepares students for life outside and the classroom as well. Engage learners to motivate problem tasks that organize build up around appealing and stimulating situation. Education involves the process of development and learning of a child in multiple dimensions, facilitated by the teacher who is guided by a curriculum. Effective education is a process where teacher, children and the school involved in a participated activity. However, a present education system emphasizes on preparing student for test and don't foster deep learning. And in the midst of the crisis of quality teaching from primary school to universities, the dominant view is that our students are not learning as much as they ideally should. And what is more worrisome is that the rote learning and memorization seems to be dominant mode at all levels. Traditional teaching approach, lecture, commonly adopted by teachers in Indian school, involves coverage of the context and rote memorization on the part of the student and does not involve students in creative thinking and participation in the creative part of activities. Most of the time during teaching learning process, instructions remain unilateral, which is considered to be orthodox activity. The upcoming trends in education change the present scenario and adopted the constructivist approach, which is modeled and more focused on innovative activities and knowledge acquisition, and therefore the academic result of the student in the classroom are better than the traditional classrooms. It was found that constructive instruction student had higher scores than the students who were exposed to the conventional method of teaching. The problem lies in the learning environment. In the conventional classrooms, the classroom environment is a teacher center, which makes learning boring or less competent students. Students' attention wants frequently and they are not able to retain the information for long periods and are often caught by daydreaming, talking, presenting other students. The individual differences existing between learners and their background knowledge and learning skills are often ignored in the conventional classrooms. Present education systems provide a unique and standardized teaching tool for all learners, which tend to benefit those who are learning and background knowledge fits well with the teaching materials. If a teaching style closely matches the students' work style, acquiring knowledge, learning becomes easy and more natural, result improved, and learning time is reduced. In few words, traditional teaching material and strategies generally tend to benefit some students more than others. The NCE also suggests adopting critical pedagogy because students are not just them for whom adults should devise solutions. They are critical observers for their own condition and needs and should be the participants in discussion and problem solving related to their education and future opportunities, which provides an opportunity to reflect critically an issue in terms of political, global, and moral aspects. The improvement in learning outcome is possible by shifting the focus of each learning process on concept development and deep understanding. Till now, most of the focus has been to ensure access to education. Therefore, a question arises on philosophical understanding for a long-term pretext. Each post-teach model of education, despite of complaining of all these tests, too many students simply are not learning. There rises a need to adopt a new methodology which encourages the learners to construct a sense of her own self of development, of her own autonomy, alongside progress within the group for interpersonal growth. Pedagogy is a vehicle of articulating learning goals and identifying the forms of activities that promotes development towards these goals. There's one such approach where activities are proposed to students that are meaningful for them and learners reflect. Such users have capacity for taking initiatives and for being creative. Constructivism is one in which activity supplements, lectures, learners are provided opportunities to construct their own understanding on the basis of an interaction that they already learned. The need of constructivism approach arises when behaviorism falls short for producing positive effect within the complex concept of the classroom and left the teachers feeling short-changed or cheated by a system that plays the guilt of student. Failure to learn in their hands. Following the legacy of behaviorism, constructivism has been welcomed as a theory of knowing that more fully explains the complexities of teaching learning process. Need of constructivism. Now we will discuss about the need of constructivism. The present article concentrates on providing an alternative based on the principle of constructivism theory given by Piaget, Vygotsky and other theoreticals, including psychologists and sociologists. If we accept this theory, then we have to give up our platonic and subsequent realistic views. We have to recognize that there is no such thing of knowledge out there, independent of the knower, but only knowledge we construct for ourselves. As we learn, is the true knowledge. If we believe that knowledge consists of learning about the real world out there, then the power of organizing and presenting the knowledge is passed on the teacher who ultimately passes this on the learner. In the process of disseminating knowledge to learners, the teacher may use activities and opportunities to experiment, but here the teacher is helping the learner understand the world, but doesn't ask the learner to construct his or her own world. The understanding of the difference between the world out there and the student's own world helps the teacher to decide the type of pedagogy he will follow to create a constructivist in the classroom. When the teacher structures situation for his own or her students, then she is restricting the learners to carry out their own mental functions. There are two words construct their own knowledge. Teacher, opting for second option, intensifies her problem because the curriculum designed by the expert classroom environment created and followed to exclusion. Instruction being given or designed, adopted, redesigned by the teacher. Theories of learning strategies of teaching and learning and the guiding principle in the framing and instructional design. The instructional design following constructivist ideology avoids directing a pupil towards a solution to the problem. Rather, it encourages self-solution. There is a need to develop a learning designing using learning strategies which follows the principle of social constructivism. Learning strategies follows the principle of social constructivism and also aims at developing social and emotional skills in students by using social constructivism in classrooms. Areas and self as a process of acquiring core cognitive skills to recognize and manage emotions, self and achieve positive goals. Appreciate the perspective of others, establish and maintain positive relationship and make precision and burden of interpersonal situation. The proximal goal of self programs are to foster the development of five interrelated sets of cognitive effective competencies, self-awareness, self-management, self-relationship, self-skillship, and responsible decision for definition of constructivism in education are as follows. It is assumed that learners have to construct their own knowledge individually and collectively. Each other has a toolkit of concepts and skills with which he or she must construct knowledge or to solve problems presented by the role of the community, other than the learner and teacher, is to provide the setting of course, the challenge, and offer the support that will encourage mathematical construction. The doctrine itself holds the language and most individually construct the meaning of word, phrase, sentence, and text. Constructivist allege that it is we who constitute a construct on the basis of theorizing or experience the unobservable outputs postulated in our theories. The central principle of this approach are the learners can only make sense of new situation in terms of their existing understanding. Learning involves an active process in which learners construct meaning by linking new ideas and existing knowledge. Social constructivism. The most important aspect on which constructivism focuses is knowledge construction. Knowledge construction is viewed differently by philosophers and psychologists. Jean Piaget viewed this constructivist because he firmly believed that knowledge acquisition is a process of continuous self-construction. Children acquire knowledge through their own action and pass through stages of assimilation, accommodation, and equity in the process of knowledge construction. The father of social construction supportive social cultural theory of learning, which accentuates the supportive ideas of mentors, and they enable the apprehensive learners to achieve successfully more complex skills, understanding, and ultimately independent competition. Vygotsky asserted that knowledge can't be isolated from the social and cultural context. He argues that the higher mental functions are the social intelligent and are embedded in the context of social cultural settings. In social constructivism, the knowledge is constructed through interaction between teacher and student. The role of a teacher is social constructivist approach. From the sole dispenser of knowledge to motivator, guide, and resource person. Constructivism emphasizes on learner's support, learner directed, and collaborative style of teaching. Learning process in which learning is supported by teacher, scaffolding authentic tasks. Now we will discuss about constructivist learning strategies. It can be developed using the principle of social constructivism to improve academic achievement, higher order thinking skills, and social emotional skills of the student. The constructivist environment is a classroom can be created by adopting the following. The first one. Provide experience with the knowledge of construction process. The teacher presents a topic to the learners and guides them to explore the topic through experimentation. The learners are encouraged to frame a research question. The teacher helps them to answer the research question framed by them through scaffolding. Second one. Experience in and appreciation for multiple perception. All learners are distinguished from each other in their way of thinking, and so the need arises to look at problems from multiple perspectives and to provide the opportunities to learn, to experiment, and discuss the alternative ways of thinking. Here the students are encouraged to work in groups, find all the groups can share their problems, opinion on the topic with each other. Third one, provide social and emotional learning. The social and emotional aspects of learning will be taught to the students in an integrated manner. The five aspects of social and emotional learning which could be covered in the teaching are the following: self-awareness, managing feelings, motivation, empathy, and social skills. Now, use of multiple modes of representation. The multiple modes of representation also assist the goal of experiencing multiple perspectives. Use of multiple media to enrich the learning environment provides the learners to view the topic being discussed in class from multiple dimensions. The teacher should prepare a list of media available and supporting the topic. Teacher should also decide the use of media in supporting the authentic nature of the task. Now let us discuss about a combination of the following learning strategies that can be used by a teacher to create constructivist learning environment. They are following. plays, scaffolding, case studies, role playing, storytelling, group discussion, group activities, reciprocal learning, probing question, project-based learning, use of learning strategies for social and emotional learning aspects. The teacher can follow under mentioned learning design while conducting group work or regional. The first situation. A situation will be present to the student to work. Second is knowledge. The teacher tries to know the existing knowledge level of the student. He tries to find out the gap in existing level and the level where they should reach at the end of the discussion. This is carried out with the help of suitable question activities. Students are then divided into groups to explore the problems present in their own perspective. Here the students of varying perspectives get included in groups. Question. The teacher may adopt the strategy of probing questions. Assist them move towards the group. Exhibit. The students are expected to exhibit or explain their own understandings regarding the topic to the other student. Reflections. Students present their reflection on the entire process of reading and understanding of the topic. Now, constructivism zone of Tomek's full development principle learning. Teachers usually focus on basic literacy routine, reading fluency, note-taking structures, skills, and test preparation due to the use of standardized testing to measure learning outcomes. This may encourage providing high support for learners and minimize attention to content knowledge development. Scaffolding comes with the rescue of teachers who want to design activities to link future action and with the present to help the learners in the development of context knowledge by development themselves. Vygotsky also talks about zone of proximal development. He developed concept of the zone as an alternative to static. Individual testing, namely IQ testing. He asserted an assessment of mental function through collaborative activities and not independent and isolated activities. Constructivism, view of knowledge acquisition emphasizes on four aspects. Knowledge construction rather than knowledge translation. And the recording of information is conveyed by others. New learning builds acquired knowledge. Learning is enhanced by social interaction. And meaningful learning develops through authenticated tasks. The role of a learner is conceived as one of the building transforming knowledge. Effective constructivism pedagogy should be based on following seven principles, as these appear to be the most common across the studies. First, emphasis is not on memorizing. Second, acquiring and using knowledge are not separate ways. Rather, knowledge is learned by using. Third, students' thinking activities and enhancing their metacognitive and self-regulative skills are embedded in the study of context of knowledge. in the assessment of the environment. The learning outcomes of the constructivist classrooms are divided into subject-based, personal transferable, and generic academic outcomes. The learning outcomes is measured by traditional examination questions belonging to the first category, subject-based outcomes. These are learning outcomes usually asserted in universities courses. However, the personal transferable outcomes such as independent work, cooperation, and communication skills, and using information, as well as generic academic outcomes such as thinking critically and synthesizing ideas and information, are learning outcomes that are supposed to be produced along with the subject-based output. However, the traditional instruction does not pay much attention to the later two. It was reported that the students in the constructivist group described their learning in terms of personal transferable skill and genetic academic outcomes, while the student control group traditional classrooms talk mainly about the genetic academic outcomes were reported more often by the group of students. However, applying constructivist principle in teaching is not an easy task. It requires strong knowledge based in the subject matter domain, and teacher needs knowledge about the process. Now we will discuss about constitution in classroom. As Pendleton quoted the arguments of Bailey, who suggested the development of learning requires giving up the current understanding of a concept to reach a new perspective, and this might be attained through interaction with peers. On the other hand, learning that doesn't require transformation of perspective, but it is characterized as acquiring a new skill, might be best attained by working and skillful partners such as adults. The guidance provided by the adult is called scaffolding, which is required to help learners to pass the zone of proximal development. The proximal development is the distance between the actual development and determined by independent problem solving, and the level of potential development as determined through problem solving under adult guidance or in collaboration with more capable peers. The common conception of the zone of proximal development and interaction between more competent person and less competent person on a task, such that the less competent person becomes independently proficient at what was initially a jointly accomplished task. The common conception of such zone of proximal development supports or inspires a vision of educational perfection. In such insightful, teacher is able to help a child master effortlessly and joyfully. A constructivist classroom is identified by percentage of the time spent on student-centered activities, and it is dominated by collaborative learning study. The activity structure studied by the foreman indicated that 70% of the class time was spent on student-centered activities, 155% devoted to the study presentation, and 55% devoted to pair maximum on her. And rest 30% time was teacher said, where teacher interaction was the facilitated rather than directed. On the other side, in a traditional classroom, only 1% time is devoted to small group work and rest of the time is devoted to independency work and teachers directed dissertation. The ratio is 15:16. The learning strategies suggest a constructivist classroom is identified by the percentage of the time spent on students, concerns, activities, and it should be dominated by collaborative learning style. The activity structure studied by a foreman indicated that 70% of the class time was spent on students' life prepared. A small group, and the rest of the time was rather than directed on the other side in the traditional classroom. 1% time is devoted to the small group, and the rest time is devoted on independent seeker and teacher directed presentation. The learning strategies suggested by Taylor and is to be included in the socially assessed learning environment. Use a reflection board in which members could share publicity, their representation, and peer collaboration reflective question. Stakeholder, shared ownership, squeezes feedback, and rewards. Daily lesson in a regular classroom. The learning strategy is that facilitates active construction of knowledge, includes use of multimedia, sporadic dialogue, scaffolding, and role-playing games, simultaneous storytelling, and case studies. Further, the pedagogical goals determine to construct constructive learning environment. Providing learning experience with the knowledge construction process, providing learning experience in application from multiple perspectives, embedded learning in realistic and relevant context, encourage ownership and voice of learning process, embedded learning in social experience, encourage the use of multiple modes of participation, encourage self-awareness, knowledge, construction process. Teaching and learning are the synonyms that we can teach and teach well without having the students learn. Most cognitive scientists now believe in constructivist model of knowledge. Second, that attempts to answer the primary question, how do we come to know? That this model can be summarized in a single statement. Knowledge is constructed in the mind of the learner. The goal of constructivism is to outline what has been called a radical constructivist model of knowledge, to describe how this model relates to the Piaget's theory and intellectual development, and to outline how this model can help understand some of the things that happens in the students. So now we will discuss about Piaget's theory of intellectual development. In the 15 years since Piaget's model of intellectual development was first brought to the attention, most of the discussion of Piaget's work among the chemists has been focused on transition between the concrete, optional, and formal operation stages, and the ways in which instruction can be devised in life. It was fascinated by the potential for exploring why students had difficulty in learning chemistry and immediately shot away test the students to separate them into concrete formal classification. Beatrix remembered that he wanted to do this, what he hoped to do with this information. Remember, being frustrated that no one could provide him with a paper and pencil test that could be used in large class and high reality, preferably in 10 minutes. In retrospect, it is obvious that some of the colleagues have praised why chemistry teachers want to identify concrete students in the beginning of the term. The ability to classify the students as concrete performer is not as important as a reality issue that there was concrete optional students in our introductory course, and even more important, everyone reverts to concrete optional and pre-optional whenever they encounter a new area. As others have repeatedly noted, Piaget was not a developmental psychologist. He was an epistemologist. He studied the development of thought in children because he believed this was only practical way of answering the question. However, to acquire knowledge, he discussed about constructive as learning strives to organize his or her experience in terms of pre-existing mental structures or schemes. He also differentiated between physical, logical, mathematical, and social knowledge. Lovejoy also differentiated between that a hall bounces or a glass vase that dropped on the floor is an example of physical knowledge. Logical mathematical knowledge consists of relationship between objects, such as comparing the wheel, the ball, and squash ball bounce. Social knowledge, such as the fact that the racket ball needs in which he played on this on Monday and Wednesday, is based on social cognition. We have also distinguished between cognitive functions such as organization and adaptation, which remains constant throughout development, and cognitive structures that changes both qualitatively and quantitatively with increasing age and experience. Adaptation of equilibrium model has been described as a calmer, self-regulating mechanism that operates through complementary biological process, assimilation and accommodation. Now let us discuss what assimilation and accommodation can only be understood in the context of Piaget's concept of cognitive structures or schema. The response to the driven of either a mother or a child own thumb is identical. A child begins to suck his thumb since very early. From the infant point of view, these triggers are distinguished, and the thumb is therefore assimilated as an object of sucking actively or skin. Assimilation involves applying pre-existing skin or mental structure to the indirect sense of time. Scheme of sucking is activated and triggered by child perception of particular pattern of sensory signals. This is a remarkable achievement when you consider that the pattern must be isolated from the indirect sensory signal at any moment in time. In no two situations provide exactly the same pattern of sound. Assimilation of the thumb to the sucking reflex requires that the child ignores difference between the visual and the tactile. signal provided by the mother and the child tap. These differences are ignored either because the child does not perceive any difference in sensory data, because of the child pays no attention to the differences that is perceived. Although this analogy focuses on reflex action of a newborn infant, assimilation of sensory pattern in the pre-existing mental structure of schemes in the constant process throughout life. We assimilate the world in the sense that we come to see it in our way. This equilibrium occurs when we cannot assimilate our experienced pre-existing scheme. When we encounter a problem because we cannot achieve it, equilibrium is resorted by modifying this pre-existing scheme until the discrepancy is resolved. The process by which existing structures are modified to fit new assimilated data is called accommodation. Once again, using Born Glasser Field example, child eventually learns to distinguish between the visual and tactile sensory that leads the will to the sensory pattern, thumb and thumb. Accommodation occurs when the child realizes that the trigger activity does not give expected result. When the child recognizes that sucking its thumb does not achieve the goal of satisfying the hunger, the child may still suck its thumb, but it's no longer accept the same result. Now we will discuss about constructivism, the traditional view of knowledge. The traditional view of knowledge is based on a common sense belief that the real world exists regardless of whether we take interest in it or even notice it. This realist perspective assumes that we come into the world as discoverers who build copies or replicates reality in our minds. This perspective leads to an ironic or a picture-like notion of knowledge in which our mental structures somewhat corresponds to the present reality. And if they were direct copies or pictures, that in turn inevitably leads to the question of how well our knowledge corresponds to reality. Something is true if and only if it corresponds to independent objective reality. According to the realist perspective, knowledge are questions of correspondence. What is true? What corresponds to that? Statement will be judged through if it corresponds to an independent existing reality and false if it is. As one classes have described that the traditional view looks for a match between knowledge and reality in much the same way that one might match two segments of knowledge. Knowledge is true when it consists of statements accurately corresponds to a match that exists in the real world. Unfortunately, as we have often reminded us, it is impossible to judge how well our mental images correspond to reality. Because the way only we can perceive reality is through these images. The grace offered one solution to the problem. Trust that God would not have been so malicious as to provide us with deceptive senses. The idealist provided another solution when they suggested that nothing exists. But the concept and ideas carried by the human mind. Luckily, we can escape the paradox without resorting either blind faith or the solipsism that makes the idealist mind as a black box. We can accurately judge what goes into the stimulus, and that comes out response. We can only guess about what is happening inside the box. The constructivist view of knowledge views the environment as black box. Each of us knows what is going in our mind. What we can only guess about the relationship between the motor structure and the real world. Now we will discuss the constructivist model of knowledge. As I suggested earlier, that the constructivist model can be summarized in the statement, knowledge is constructed in the mind of the learner. It has been described in somewhat greater detail as follows. Learner construct understanding. They do not simply mirror and reflect what they are told or what they are thinking. Learners look meaning and they try to find the clarity and other in the events of the world in the absence of foreign complete information. However, anyone who has studied chemistry or tried to teach it on other knows that the active students are more than passive students. Chemists should therefore have a natural affinity for a model which replaces more or less passive replicant of knowledge with an active learner. The problem with constructivism arises when one tries to look at the logical consequence of the assumption that knowledge is constructed in the mind of von Clausewitz has definitely described construction of knowledge as such a fit rather than match. 1, 3, 1, 2, 3, 6, 7 is a constructivist model of knowledge as in reality, the way a key fits a lock. And the difference between concept of fit and match that shows radical constructivism differs from the traditional view of knowledge. As long as we adhere to the traditional view in which knowledge corresponds or matches reality, to a more traditional view in such knowledge corresponds with individuals, the same knowledge must have similar properties, reflects reality in the mind. Once we allow knowledge to fit reality the way a key fits the world, we find ourselves in a very different position because many keys with different shapes that open a different path. Each of us build our own reality by trying to find order in the chaos of sequence that impinge our own senses. The only things that matter is whether the knowledge we construct from this information functions satisfactorily in the context in which it arises. The constructivist model is an instrumental view of knowledge. Knowledge is good if and when it comes, if and when it allows us to achieve knowledge. A similar view was taken by Osiander, who suggested in the preface to Copernicus, there is no need for these hypotheses to be true or even to be at all likely. Rather, one thing is sufficient for them, that they yield calculation with a V with the observation. Piaget and constructivism. Much of this reaction to the Piaget's work, both pro and con, has been the result of the natural tendency to assimilate writing into existing conceptual structures based on the traditional view of knowledge. This is unfortunate because Piaget holds constructivist, although a constructivist perspective has been traced back to the writing. Piaget was the first constructivist in the sense that his belief that knowledge was constructed in the mind of the learner was based on research in how to acquire knowledge. So let us discuss about the extent of Piaget's commitment to constructivism. The student led brief description of the period between birth and acquisition of knowledge. At 18 months, 2 years, the sensory motor assimilation, the immediate external world, affects the miniature in cognition. At the starting point of this development, the neo may grasp everything produced, or in precise terms, it is more than that. Wherever the termination of the period when language and thought begin, is full of practical purpose, an element of entity among others in the rules that he has gradually constructed himself, and which hereafter will experience as external to himself. It is believed that knowledge is acquired as a result of lifelong constructive process, in which we try to organize structure and restructure our experience in light of existing skills, and thereby gradually modify, expand senses and skills. Indeed, this definition of knowledge at invariance under transformation has no meaning outside the constructivist perspective. We have argued that objects appear permanent or inbuilt as a result of the individual cognition, experimental data, and subsequent projection of these coordination onto the world that lies beyond our senses. The data we receive from our senses and cognitive structures, the schemes we use to explain these data from both exist within the mind. Von Weissenfeld has argued that assimilation occurs when what we perceive is adjusted to fit the conceptual structures we have already assembled. If that does not work, then our experience does not fit our ideas. Equilibration can occur by adjusting the filtered sensory data we perceive, and this process is known as accommodation. Perhaps the best way of demonstrating and perception are assimilated into existing cognitive structures or scheme is the example described by John Glasser. In other words, assimilation does not find recurring patterns of sensory data, but imposes patterns by ignoring difference between what we perceive, what is expected between the visual pattern of a head, airborne palate, and visual pattern. How can knowledge be valued in the constructivist model? Let us discuss about it. The constructivist model raises an important question. If individuals construct their own knowledge, how can a group of people appear to share common knowledge? A very important question. The key to answering this question is re-memorizing the knowledge in a swift way. Construction is a process in which knowledge is both built and continually tested. Individuals are not free to construct any knowledge. Their knowledge must be vital. It must work non-classically or deeply. That our experience test the validity of knowledge is much the same way that Darwin's theory of evolution tests the validity of an hypothesis. Darwin's theory of evolution is based on the principle of something, not cause that effect, natural selection, and the means of medicine does not fit operating the same criteria. not surprising that when a group of individuals with similar interests gather at ACS meeting, the external observer group does similar. They share common knowledge. So everyday experience individuals on thought in physics generally assumes that a force is always necessary to sustain motion, even at steady speed. This idea and that are related to some quite evidence for the constructive mind. What evidence do you have that knowledge is constructed in the mind of the learner? And if it fits rather than matches reality? It is tempting to answer this question by noting that anyone who has ever witnessed an argument between a liberal Democrat and conservative Republican should appreciate the fact that individuals not only construct their own knowledge, but based on pre-existing cognitive structure or schemes, but in fact also seem to construct very different worlds in which we live. A more appropriate answer might cite in the result of research that led to the constructive model that would take far too much space. I have to refer tired to the select individual experiments that might land the key to the element of the mind. Regardless, whether knowledge is constructed in the mind of the learner or corresponds to an ionic image or picture of the mind, it must be based on the perception of the learner. Faced with the question, how accurately a sense depicts reality? Regardless, suggested trusting in our beneficial God who would not provide us with respective senses. There is a good reason, however, to question reality but as sense. In the last, I would like to say the focus of education needs to be shifted from placing contents in the student's knowledge within. If the focus of studying could be turned from filling one mind to producing knowledge products, student wouldn't need to constantly memorize and cramping for examinations. These knowledge products could be in the form of essay, terms, paper, project reports, videos, posters, slides, portfolios, or however, products that student might create in classroom introduction. There is a need of integration of formal, theoretical, practical, self-regulated knowledge. However, in the traditional type of curriculum, these different types of knowledge have been treated separately. One of the most challenges to the pedagogy is developing curriculum and teaching methods so that integration of the formal, theoretical knowledge and more informal assessment cannot be left untouched by constructivism as contrast to learning. Requires an entirely different approach to assessment, an approach that is qualitative in nature. Competitive assessment based on real-life task performance assessments. This type of assessments emphasize on student learning process and on the meaning making much of even on the final project. How can knowledge be constructed at one? Letting establish a frog visual system that makes a frog an efficient night catcher because it is turned to a small dark object that moves to another grand object. In the frog's natural habitat, every item that possesses the characteristic necessary to trigger on the frog depicted in a proper sequence in a fly or bug or other morsel of food for the frog. But if the frog is presented with a black another dark moving item, it will snap up through. It can fly. In fact, no normal frog is like this. Apparatus, anything that triggers the dictator in the right way. Role of Mill's conception of the construction model helps to explain why students bring misconceptions of chemistry, physics, and mathematics, and why these misconceptions are so remarkably resistant to instruction. Let us start discussing between preconception and a preconception is a concept or idea which a student has upon entering a course with some consequence on persons. We shall use the term misconception for concept or idea which, from the point of view at which the professional leads to the unacceptable solution answer to the question problems in the practice. So, for the conclusion, I would like to say that focus of education needs to be shifted from basic content in the student's knowledge area. The focus of studying could be turned from filling one's mind or producing knowledge products. Students wouldn't need to concentrate. So, I think the topic is clear with everyone. Thank you so much.